So maybe the first item is more for me, as it's more related to the future possibility for DOA in Europe to approve STC. Today, all STC are approved by EASA. So validation is any case coming to by EASA, but I would say the approval is issued by EASA. Tomorrow, with a revision of Part 21, we may extend the privilege for DOA to approve some STC. And the question was, what will happen for the validation if we need the validation of such STC? Once again, the DOA is part of the EASA system, so I don't see why NVFA is already accepting some approval issued by DOA, such as repairs. And it's not because it's not approved directly by EASA, but it cannot be validated by FA. For the timing, STC are still subject to validation. We are not ready for acceptance of STC. So definitely a DOA, an STC approved by a DOA will be still subject to validation. The FA will have to issue its own STC based on the STC issued by the DOA. So I don't see why it will change the validation process.
Sorry, Jean-Louis, just one recommendation. Because we have also the other presentation and we have also the closure, I would say I would avoid to open again the debate. So let's really share with us the results of what has, you know, of your discussions.
Just for the audience, also for all of us.
So this is really the collections of the outcomes. And so it's just a recommendation. Thank you very much.
You want to speak about additive manufacturing?
Well, we received the one of the comments that came up during the conversation was the questioning about novel, new and novel type technology, and how do we make a determination? And that came out of the additive manufacturing aspect. And trying to determine the novel, new and novel aspect for the validating authority, it is a challenging aspect. But as you saw earlier, you had a presentation on new and novel, and it is still a very new and novel aspect, the additive manufacturing. So it is challenging, I will tell you that, and it's, you know, what I would advise is to communicate with your authority, EASA, or the FAA, and we can try to provide insight to the best of our knowledge of what's there, because there really isn't a true list that you can go and look at and say, well, this is new or this is novel.
Okay, another subject was the fact that even with a streamlined process, validation of a US STC today takes, in average, 3 to 4 days, but it seems that for some organizations, like operators, it's still too long. I am afraid that until we are able to go to the acceptance of STC, it would be really difficult to go faster than that. Sorry about that, but it's the case.
One of the other questions came up with regards to the inconsistencies between the drawing lists of the FAA STC validated by EASA. Well, with regards to the drawing lists, you know, it's a nice tool to help define the type design, and we're looking to have a good harmonized approval between the both authorities. So both of our authorities should line up, and we shouldn't have the inconsistencies is what we're shooting for. We're looking for that harmonization.
Yeah. So I think the two subjects were linked. And we have still some work to do on this AML validation. And the last question was about FAR 26. We have some TCDS issued by VFA, which include not only FAR 25, but also FAR 26. Until now, we have not CX 26. It's coming. But definitely, you have to consider it's like SSD. It's not really a SSD, because SSD has limited to FAR 25 or FAR 20. But I would say it's definitely an additional requirement from VFA, and the demonstration of compliance to this specific requirement should be demonstrated as you do for the FAA certification basis when it is FAR 25 or other regulation. And I'm afraid the 5 minutes are finished. This is the main items which have been discussed yesterday during this side meeting.
Thank you very much.